Right. Now let me see the next concept, last concept of this chapter, multimedia. So multimedia talks about is a combination of having the different formats, like not only image, we'll have supports, music, sound, videos, records, films, animation, all combinations will comes under multi. Normally media means what? Which can be represent the content in a style, in a one style manner, it comes under media. That media is a multiple in the sense, image is a, if you combine three or four images, if you move some objects over there in the moving some motion to that images, it comes under a media. If you have audio, is one type of media. Video, sounds, all combination. So combination of supporting different formats is called as multimedia. So web pages normally contains multimedia elements. What are the multimedia elements it consisting? Let me see. Before going to that one, let me see the different formats for multimedia. Like for images, it's a JPG or GIF or PNG. These are the formats for images. Like for this multimedia formats, .swf, .wav, .mp3, .mp4, .mpg, .wav, .wmv, .avi. These are the different formats which supports by this multimedia. Now let me have look into the different syntaxes which supports this multimedia. I'll just open the hyperlink where what you need to write in the examination as well. Now if you look out into this screen, hope it is visible. Right, video formats, MPEG. So like we have a JPEG, Joint Picture Expert Group, JPEG. Here we have MPEG, right? So AVI, which stands for Audio Video Interface. WMV, which stands for Windows Media Video. Like we have a QuickTime, Real Video, Flash, OOG, all such type of videos it's going to be supporting over here. So different formats, their purposes. I have just listed out to you. And these are some of the audio formats, MDI. So MIDI, M-I-D-I, MIDI full form is Musical Instrument Digital Interface, MIDI. And maybe have real audio. If you have changed the software to listen that one, different formats will be, it has to come into picture. WMA, which stands for, previously we have V for video, WMV. Is a Windows Media Video. This is a Windows Media Audio. And AAC, Advanced Audio Coding. And WAV, like this, different formats for audio as well. And OOG is also be there. OOG. And MP3 also be there. MP4. And most of the formats are already aware about this. Right. So this is some description where we can add it. Now, let me look into how we are going to be inserting a video. How we can be inserting an audio inside our pages. Let me see the syntaxes. If you see here, the syntax is same. Like it's a IMG, how we are inserting the image. This also the same syntax, only it is changed video. When you want to insert a video, you need to use video element. Now I'm giving the width as 320, the height as 240. And I'm using controls. Hope controls in the nothing but play symbol, forward symbol, backward symbol, volume. Such type of controls, if you want to be enabled, you can use the attribute called as controls. Now, in this video frame, I am inserting a source. We have to be a subtag for the video called as source. Source will define what are the different videos you are going to be adding. That source will decide. SRC equal to, you are giving movie.mp4 and the type of the video. It is MP4 or OOG, what is the format you are supposed. If it doesn't support, so your browser does not support this video tag. Like this, the message will display. If you see play of this, you see the supporting files is not there. We'll look into it. Here video, I'll just open the code. We'll see one example here. See, same example, movie.mp4, movie.org, and sources. First of all, let me see whether this is there or not. MP movie dot MP4 is there. Now I'll run this video. See, hope it is visible to you. Now see, it is visible, right? Just a minute. Right. Now see here. You are getting sound overall. Right. So here controls is nothing but here we are saying this is the width and height. We are mentioning the frame. Now controls in the, if you're not using controls means this plus play symbol, this volume, this zooming. Only few controls will become by default. The other will not become when you're not using controls. Now if I am using here, I'll just remove this also. Let me see. I'm just saving the program. I'm adding one more video for this. Same. One more video in the sense. Please will comment this. Movie.org. So movie.org is not here. Right? We'll add this MP3. Dot MP3. That is the file. Let me see. Whether it is added. Because doesn't support adding. Just showing you an example that MP3 whether it supports or not. Okay, fine, no issue. So like this, you can add any number of the videos inside that frame. If you want to increase the size of the width and height, it will also allow. That is one example for video. Now let me see for the audio. Another example for audio. Now same, what you are doing in the audio is, what we are doing is, here we are just adding with the help of audio. Just we are using controls. Same sub tag for the audio tag also. Sub tag is source, src, abc.org. Just fluent ringtone. This is, we can play over this. Because you are adding inside the tag of audio. This is source. That's why previously it is not supports in the video, the MP3. Right. So now it is, let me see if we run the program. I will go to the program example. So here the audio. Here the audio. See, I'm just adding a audio control source src equal to horse.org. So in the back end, I have only one file. There is no horse.org file. So whenever you are running this program, please look it into that whether the back end supporting images and MP3 or audio, whatever it is there or not. Because simply if you are running that, it is not possible. Okay. Please take care of that. I will run the program. Hope you are visible this. I'll just wait for this. Talk later about this. See, just we are adding audio, audio file. This, how it is going to display over this. Okay. So when you are running your websites, by default a background sound comes like this. Also, you can add it, a silent music in the back end. This also you can hide this tag. Right. So hope you understand how we can add the audio. Is clear? Now one more very important concept and very interesting also. You please add also in week one programs what I am saying, the last concept, that is embedded option. You can also add video and audio. That's what I am saying. Your own website, your own interest, I don't have. First of all, fulfill the how the page look like, 1A, 1B, 1C. The rest of the things, like instead of displaying home description, you can add your own how your bookstore look like, how your bookstore. You can create a video, you can add it. Or any beautiful video, if you available in the YouTube also or in any other link, you can directly add it. But here, when you open your website, in one part, automatically, it has to be display the YouTube frame directly. Now, instead of after clicking that hyperlink, it not be play. Automatically, it has to display in that. So how we can do is, we have an option called as embedded option, YouTube embedded option. Now, how you can do this embedded video, embedded added means, for example, you like someone video in YouTube. That code, if you take that frame code, and if you copy inside your HTML page, automatically it will be display the video frame automatically in your website. So how we can do means, let me see that. Now I'm opening YouTube. So I'm just opening my channel itself. Inside this, we have all the concept. For example, let me add this HTML pages for this HTML table.
Right. So let me discuss about the next topic.
Want to in our add this frame HTML. For example, I'm saying if you want to be add this in your website, this frame, if you right click on this, there is an option called as copy embedded code. Are you looking here? If you right click on the video, there is a right click on the video. If you right click on this video, if you right click, it will show you copy embedded code. Just click on copy embedded code. Once you copy, come to your page. For example, if this is a page, just paste this. I'm just pressing Ctrl V. Paste. So see, this is how already I discussed you adding one website content into another website. That is the iframe, right? Iframe code. That here we are adding iframe of width, height, so on. So this is the SRC. By default, it comes frame border, allow accelerator meter, autoplay, encrypted media. This is all default it will get when you copy the embedded code from that frame. Not only my video, you can take any video which you like to be. You copy the embedded code, paste wherever you require. So this is how it will be comes iframe. What is the purpose of iframe? Displaying or showing the content of one website content into another website. That is simply called as iframe. I'm just saving here. So previously, how the output look like for audio? Where I'm adding in the audio example, right? This is how. I'm just refreshing. If you refresh, see, by default, without a hyperlink, it will be directly play in your website. Are you getting this? Directly, I'm just running here. I'm not playing in the YouTube. In your program directly, where in the previous program is there, right? In the previous example, the audio example is there. There I am added this iframe. Automatically it is added the frame of size, whatever it will be, fix it. If you want reduce, you can also reduce that one. If you play here, it is not navigated to YouTube. Directly to play from here, if you have connected with internet. See?
Right. So let me discuss about the next topic in our HTML 4. Is creating tables and columns are called as tags. So that's why it is mentioning. So TR also, if you reduce this one self padding, it will come closer to that. So like this, we can add any number of, we can add a audio, we can add an
closer
video.
To that, it will comes anything we can do it. So like this, you can beautifully design. Just only required is some patience. Just you can have some sort of patience over here. That is more than enough. So by this, we have done the first chapter of web technology.